Well, the only way to describe last night's grand finale of MasterChef is epic. Fans and favourites wound up last night and there could only be one winner. Ten.
That means Billie McKay, you're the winner of MasterChef Australia 2022!
You are now the first cook ever to win MasterChef Australia. Not once, but twice.
Give it up for Billie McKay!
Billie won the title of MasterChef Australia champ for the second time, but man, was it a close race to the finish line. And this morning we are joined by runner-up Sarah, who is live from Melbourne. Sarah, congratulations first on such an incredible cook last night. It was so, so close. It was hard to pick a winner for us anyway. But how did you find last night's grand finale?
Oh, it was awesome. I walked into the grand finale just feeling so happy. I think we made it all the way to the end. And I mean, Billie, come on, you've won once before, just share it around. Like, but it was amazing. It was. It was a great challenge.
Well, you brought out the big guns last night, cooked up an absolute storm, and you were in the lead by 5 points. How did you feel at that point in time?
I just know that Billie's amazing at pressure tests and especially dessert pressure tests. So I knew I was kind of up against it going into that round, but I felt good. I think for me, it's more about feeling happy and proud in my cook and what I did on the day. And I definitely feel proud with how I'm walking out of the MasterChef kitchen.
Mm. Oh, and so you should be. I mean, this is your second time on MasterChef. You started in season 6. How can you compare the experiences?
I think it was so different. This time round, I definitely felt like I had a lot more experience. So there was a lot of tools kind of in my backpack to be kind of ready for all of the challenges. But in saying that, it's MasterChef and they really stepped it up a notch for all of us. And we really felt it. It was definitely challenging and I grew as well, which I didn't expect to do coming back.
Yeah, well, you're a mother to your beautiful son, Phoenix, who we saw last night. Now, he was only 2 when you first went on MasterChef. How was he there watching you last night with a bit more of appreciation of it all?
You know what? He really keeps it very real. I was chatting with him, like, it was a couple of weeks ago. Someone asked me, do I think I can win? I was like, yeah, of course, you know, being that strong mum, like, confident, showing him how it's done. And then he's like, but do you really think you can win? I'm like, hey! So he's amazing and he's so proud and yeah, he definitely keeps it very real.
no doubt he is very proud. And he's keeping an eye on that cash prize as well. Now, you whipped up some insane dishes this year. Do you have a favourite that you got to do? I mean, where do you get your inspiration from?
I definitely think I found my niche in this season of MasterChef, and it was the dish, my lobster dish, where it was a taste of India with French techniques. And I really feel like in life, you're always searching for your specific style. And I think I really found it this season. So I did a lot of dishes where there were that kind of French and Indian flavors, which has become my style now. So I feel really thankful for that, actually.
That's brilliant. Well, Sarah, we've had so many fans send in beautiful questions for you. Could you possibly stick around so we can fire them at you?
Go for it.
Can't
wait. We'll be right back with your questions for Sarah right after this.
Adieu.